The Impact Lounge is the number one place to be for the real Impact Wrestling fans. What's up, everybody? BQ here. This is the Impact Lounge. Make sure to hit that subscribe button if you're a first timer. Was talking about this not too long ago in one of my most recent uploads. Jeff Jarrett sues Anthem for monetizing his Global Force Wrestling brand. I get it. Let me be clear. If I felt that someone owed me $20, I'd want that $20 back. If Anthem made $2 off that GFW stuff, he's going to want that money. Roger that. I get it. It's his money as far as he's concerned. And I think it is. I'm not going to beat a dead horse on a story. Aside from the financial considerations, I think his main goal, however, is to just get his hands on the masters for the Global Force Wrestling amp. That's what he feels is his property, his baby, and his copyrighted material. If you've already read this article online, you may be unsure of what a memorandum of law is. And this apparently was not featured in the initial motion filed by Jeff Jarrett and his lawyers. So stick around to the end of this video and I'm going to explain to you what a memorandum of law is. A day or so ago, he files another motion saying Anthem has not responded. He wants his master copies back and in his possession to make his copies. They are his, so I don't think anyone disputes that part of this whole thing. The nonsense is just the use of the amped programming and the title belts. Anthem has complied, however. They took the GFW stuff down from the website and the Global Wrestling Network. Before I get into the meat and potatoes of this, let me say, I don't dislike Jeff Jarrett. I met him once. He didn't really say a whole lot. Karen, on the other hand, is a sweetheart. I thought she was great. Liked her a lot. I think he's made some good decisions. I think he's made some bad ones. But I'm not sure this guy totally has his shit together. Maybe it's a mental thing. You're going to tell me that you allowed a televised change of Impact Wrestling to Global Force Wrestling, promoted ahead of time that the next four nights, the next four one-night-onlys, rather, were GFW amped, and you didn't have the necessary paperwork in place, your attorneys didn't draw up a single document to protect you in the case that you were relieved of your duties. That's like me giving Adam the password to the YouTube channel. I'm shit out of luck because I didn't do anything to protect myself. It's like allowing another guy into the bedroom, not telling him to wear a condom, and he gets your old lady pregnant. Well, it's your problem now, buddy. Protect what's yours. Take care of your shit. But at least he has his masters copyrighted. And as I've said earlier, this is total speculation. I'm obviously not directly involved in this in any way whatsoever. This is all opinion, speculation. But there was probably some kind of letter of intent accomplished, which I think will protect Anthem for the most part in this whole debacle. So as far as the headline of this video, Jeff Jarrett and Global Wrestling Entertainment are denied the expedited discovery of the GFW master copies access so they can be copied. The court denied this order, ruling that it hasn't even been confirmed that Anthem has even been officially served the lawsuit. It was added that the motion wasn't even sent to Anthem's attorneys, but rather a registered agent that works for Anthem. So finally, the court rules that the original motion features no memorandum of law, and it wasn't attached to prove Jeff Jarrett's arguments. This goes back to me saying he doesn't have his shit together. He at least doesn't appear to. So what's a memorandum of law, you ask? I'm not a legal expert, said that in my last video covering this whole thing, so I can only break this down as I understand it. If anyone could break it down better, if they understand it like the back of their hand, please do so in the comments below. You can educate me, whatever the case is. So a memorandum of law in simple terms serves as a timeline or an outline of the sequence of events. Basically, on this day, we entered into a verbal agreement to begin the merge of Impact and Global Force Wrestling. At this time, we changed the name from Impact to GFW, so on and so forth. You get the idea. This allows all parties involved, as well as the judge assigned to the case, reference points that they can recall the events and sequence leading up to where the alleged issues occurred. Now, this isn't a document that's done to like persuade the judge, oh, well, they did this and this and this. It's supposed to be written really objectively, but rather it's to be accomplished, okay, on this date, this happened, and according to this law, they violated blah, 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 blah. So it's, again, it's supposed to be written objectively and basically state how the law would apply to each fact that happened. So when I say I was shown the exit on this date, they continued to monetize, they did this. This was the violation. This is where it occurred. So we'll see what happens next time, but it seems like Jeff Jarrett may have to go back to the drawing board a little bit before he takes on a company like Anthem Sports. So keep it locked. We're going to follow the story, see what's going on, and thanks for listening.